My dear friends, welcome to Sunday Reflection from the Sur Sangam devotional channel. This Sunday, we will be discussing about power and service. I just want to begin with a little episode which you have heard many times. When American independence took place, they were struggling to rebuild the country. And it is then some of the soldiers were riding on a vehicle. They were caught in a slush. And all the soldiers got up to push the vehicle out of the slush, but they were not able to. And then another vehicle comes there. And the person in charge looks there at the servants and all those soldiers struggling. But the man in charge of that vehicle was not doing anything. Then he said, "Why don't you go and help them?" He said, "I am the corporal. Why should I do that?" Then this man got down from his vehicle and helped them. And somehow they struggled and the vehicle came out. Then that man said, "Who are you?" He said, "I am George Washington." You know, George Washington was the first president of the United States of America. George Washington did not feel bad because he felt, although I am the president, I should go and help those people. Service is more important. My dear friends, today, similar thing happens in the life of Jesus. Jesus was with his disciples for a long, long time. And today, somehow he sees them talking among themselves. Two of them were discussing that where are we going to be in the kingdom of Jesus? And Jesus comes and asks them, "What do you want?" And they say, "When your kingdom is established, where are we going to be? Which position?" And Jesus says, "Which position? What do you mean? Are you ready to drink the cup which I am ready to drink?" Dear friends, all these people were waiting for a new kingdom to be established because the Romans were ruling over them. And once the Romans would be out, they expected Jesus to be the hero who would once again gather all the people and they would rule the country. And then, as it happens in the world today, they all would have been given a position each, a mantri, or a chief minister, or whatever that may be. Then Jesus tells them, "My kingdom is a different kingdom. I have come to serve and not to be served. And therefore, if you want to follow me, then you got to follow my example. Namely, it is not the question of ruling, but the question of serving. It is in serving that I would like to rule. And therefore, there are no positions in my kingdom. No such people as big and small. One who wants to be great is the one who wants to be the servant of all." My dear brothers and sisters, there is something difficult for all of us, even me, or even anyone else for that matter. When you come to any society, who wants to be the one who is ready to serve? The servants. Servants are always secondary. The rulers are always on the top. The owners are the people who rule over them. But very often, they subjugate them. They dominate over them. They ill-treat them. That is the question. Jesus says no. Power is the one which we get by serving, by loving, by forgiving, by understanding, which is difficult. And Jesus tells them that such a power is possible only when we are ready to struggle for it. Therefore, he says, "My power comes from the cross. My power comes from the time that I am ready to struggle for it. That is the power that I want. And that is the type of kingdom that I wish to establish. And if you are ready to walk with me, if you are ready to drink that cup of difficulties, then only you must follow me." Perhaps His disciples did not understand at that time. But slowly, as he embraced his cross and died on the cross and he rose again, they understood the meaning of what he had said. My dear brothers and sisters, today if the world is suffering, it is not because people are not ready to serve. It is because people just want to dominate. They want to feel above others. They want to feel that they are greater than other people. You and I, in this world, no matter which religion we belong, once we begin to have that type of understanding, we will never ever serve. And all those who call themselves, who want a position to serve, they are just bluffing. They are not telling the truth. It is because of that they have more positions. It is because of that they grab all the power for themselves. Power is the power of service. And that is the greatest power in the world. That is the reason why the Nobel Peace Committee told about Mother Teresa that she is the most powerful woman in the world. Hence, let us reflect upon these readings this Sunday. And let us try to change this attitude, not just the position. When we change the attitude, we too will be like Jesus, who came to serve and not to be served. Have a nice day.